Is everybody, has everybody had a good work camp? So what we're going to talk about today is kind of my exploration into shopping carts and some of the different things I look for and look at for different things. So a little bit about me. We started doing video for the web way back in 1999. And if you don't remember back that far, do you remember having to go to a website and they'd say, oh, do you want a quick play movie or do you want a media player? Well, we were before that. We were putting videos for people on the web. So there was no YouTube and it was very difficult. So about the same time, we'd be looking at the people's websites that wanted video, and we'd be going, you know, like, you know, it's okay for video, but, you know, you need, maybe you need something a little bit more. So in 2002, we became TRB Designs, and we started doing video and a little bit of web. In 2004, we started a company called Gym Smarts. And my husband has a background in gymnastics, and we were doing video for all sorts of other people. And one of his friends said, gosh, can you, like, film gymnastics? And we thought, gosh, I don't know, something we know about? So we started doing Gym Smarts. And what we did was we filmed coaches who were teaching elite gymnasts. So it was a very, very niche market. And so this was the very first website we put up. We didn't even know if people were going to purchase videos for gymnastics coaches, let alone, you know, how many we could do. So we started out with about 12 different videos, DVDs that we put up for sale, and we just put it up one day and we sat and waited. So that was our little horrible website. So eventually we said, okay, we're selling videos, and there is a market, even though Google said there wasn't. We started to create a niche market for gymnastics training videos. So then we said, okay, we need something more than just, you know, somebody calling on the phone saying, yes, I'd like to buy three of your videos. So we started looking around at what was out there at the time and what major ones that are out there even now. So here's some of the free and some of the premium. If you just look for shopping carts, here's some of them out there. This is obviously a small sampling, but OS Commerce, Magneto, Zen Card, Miva Merchant is really big for a lot of the web hosting companies use it. X Card. One Shopping Cart is a hosted service, and Volution is another one. There's like a massive amount of different ways you can sell stuff on the web. So in 2003, there weren't a lot of solutions, and this one here, we decided to go with Miva Merchant because we still weren't sure if this was going to take off or not. And it was one of those shopping carts that came with our hosting service, and we signed up for it and got it going, and it was okay, but obviously it wasn't going pretty. So in 2006, we decided, okay, this business is taking off. We went to some very, very great graphic design people, and we created this website over here. And with that, they said, why don't you go with an online service? So we went with One Shopping Cart. And One Shopping Cart is an online service, and you have to have, you have to pay a monthly fee. So we were doing that for another 5 or 6 years. And then we started to evolve with our web service, and we started working with WordPress. We started building simple sites, and we started moving sites to WordPress that were WordPress already. And then after month of us paying $99 to One Shopping Cart, we decided we were ready for a new solution, and I was into WordPress enough that, you know, I really wanted our site to be WordPress, and I wanted it to look nice and I wanted to have that as a showcase for us, and we're just ready for a new solution. So online, there's plenty of third-party shopping carts, both premium and free. They have a variety of different features, and we'll go over some of the main ones and some of the more premium ones. And they vary from a very simple point solution to a robust full-featured platform. So I'm showing right there, I don't know if you can see it very well, but if you do a plugin search on shopping carts, you get 180 different plugins that you can look at. Right there. So before you start delving into that 180 different plugins you can use, you have to ask yourself some questions. And these are some of the ones that I ask our clients and I feel are very important before you even look at a shopping cart. So the first question is products. Do you have just a few products? Or do you have hundreds or thousands of products? Do you have a variation of your products? Do you sell a t-shirt with different colors, different sizes? Do you have different features that you want to add on to your different products? That's something to take into consideration. Do you have a membership or subscription service that you want to promote for your shopping cart? Do you want to include your current payments? Are your products digital, where they can just download it, or are they physical products? All these things you have to keep in mind when you're thinking about the shopping cart. The next thing is payments. How will you process the payments? Are you going to use PayPal? Are you going to use Google? Or are you going to go delve into a full merchant account? If you do a full merchant account, you have to be aware that there's a few different levels. And I don't know how easily everybody can see this, but a user places an order, it goes to a merchant or a merchant server, then to a payment gateway to the bank, and then the merchant receives the payment. And then once the merchant receives the payment, it goes back, and the user gets their order. Some shopping carts that we're going to look at today require that you have a secure socket layer on your website. Some don't. The secure socket is that little lock that you see on a website. It's the HTTPS. And if you're putting a shopping cart on your site that requires one of them, it's a little bit trickier to get it live and get it started going. If you do need a secure socket solution, I recommend a company called Namecheap. You can purchase them for a lot less than what the merchant services are saying your products are. I think they got mine for like $4 for the year, as opposed to the $75 to $300 I've seen. But what that does is it's a protocol and it encrypts all the information being sent back and forth from the customer to your site and to the bank and back. Another question is shipping. Do you need shipping or are you going to do just ebooks? If you need shipping, where are you planning to send it to? Are you selling to the US? Are you selling to Canada? Are you selling worldwide? There's a lot of different things you have to think about if you're shipping things overseas. If you do have shipping, are you going to ship it via U.S. Postal Service, or are you going to use some of the other services out there? And a lot of these, from experience, I know it depends on weight, which is best. Like if most of your products are like over 10 pounds and it's the Postal Service may not be the best way, but if it's under, Postal Service is a good way to ship things even worldwide. And with our gymnastics DVDs, we definitely chose the U.S. Postal Service because it's a lightweight product and they're flat rates that we can send So, would there be handling fees associated with your products? Do you want something to add to the cost? With our gymnastics DVDs, would you add on top of the regular shipping fees a handling fee? Because we physically have to run off to the post office and drop it off, and so we feel we should get a couple extra dollars each time somebody buys a product. We don't want each product to have a shipping fee, we want it to be on each order. And a lot of the shopping carts don't allow for that. I'll tell you that. So, shopping cart solutions. There's a few different ways you can go. You can go with a shopping cart plug-in. You can go with shopping cart hybrids, which are themes with shopping carts in them. You can go with a lightweight shopping cart, which has maybe just a few functions, and it depends on how many items you're selling, whether that's a good solution for you or not. And you can also go with plugins that integrate with third-party carts, like One Shopping Cart and Volution. So the ones that we're going to look at right now are shopping carts as plugins. So some of the standard shopping cart features are that all of them, most of them, will have a product catalog. And this is a back-end shot of WooCommerce. And there's the catalog part of it. And you have the options of sorting alphabetically, sorting by last put in, the date of, or price, and then they have different units of measurement and things that you can put in there to get the catalog so it's all consistent. Most of them have an inventory management system so that you can say there's, you know, 10 of these in stock. And there's a place where you can do low stock threshold where it will tell you once your threshold gets to 2 in this case, that you need to purchase more for your back information, or you know, you can say when it's out of stock so that you can order more. You can either have the items still show up if they're out of stock, or you can hide the items. And the other thing that was interesting with the WooCommerce thing, you can do a stock display format where you can say it always shows 12 in stock so that people don't ever think that you're out. And that's something good for us when we're doing DVDs because we do it on demand. So if we always want to say our items are in stock. Okay, most of them have an order management system, so once somebody purchases the item, this is a sales summary. So, and this is off of the SHOP program, S-H-O-P-P. And so they have a sales summary that tells you that you have 4 orders for the month, a total of 320 purchases, what your goal, since we put in the plugin, this is how many orders, and sales by month, and you can, this is all in the dashboard once you install, once you install Shop. But many of them are similar to that. So most of them are somewhat SEO friendly. In the case of Shop, or I'm sorry, not Shop, this is e-commerce. E-commerce has the meta information, they have the RSS feeds, they integrate with Google and the Google Sitemaps, and then if you want additional plugins, they also integrate with some of the more popular WordPress plugins. This is kind of a standard little shipping settings. You can, on most of the shopping carts, you can either say, I want the shipping for product or for weight, or and a handling fee. So then how your weights per ounce or per pound, if you want to use dimensions, and some of the different options for shopping carts. Taxes, if you're not just selling in your state, you need to maybe, verify what state you're collecting tax for, and some of the shopping carts even include an estimate for the VAT, that tax. Shop was not, but I was looking over some of the feedback on some of the shopping carts, and some of them do an estimate for them. Okay, so next thing is that payment gateways. Most of the shopping carts have a number of different payment gateways you can use. Some of the shopping carts I'm going to be showing you, the free version maybe has a limited amount of payment gateways, and some of you may have to buy additional plugins so that you can get some of these different more advanced payment gateways. Some of the advanced premium features are that you have product variants. So right here we have t-shirt size, and you're able to choose an option. Color, you'll be able to choose an option. This is how you do it on the back end. You just kind of check off the variants that you want to use, and they show up on the front end. Okay, some of the other advanced premium features are discounts and promotions. This is just an example of shop, and it's very easy just to throw in a discount. You just say if you want an amount off, or you want a percentage off, or you want orders over $300 get something off. It's very easy just to put in your little coupon code and get a discount. And it's another example over here of, this is the actual payment option. Once people get to the payment portion, they're able to put that little promo code in and they'll get this discount. So a few of the other advanced premium options is affiliate options. If you want somebody to refer people to your site, some of the shopping carts have those options for affiliates. And then template tags and short codes, a lot of the premium shopping carts have those features so that you can create a page and then use the short code to put whatever kind of display you want on it. Support and documentation. Once you purchase a premium, there's usually a higher level of support, and the documentation is usually more in-depth than if you're using the free call. And the other thing is that the developer API is available if you go into that. Okay, so some of the free shopping carts. I'm just going to take a quick look at some of the more popular ones. WP e-commerce is at getshop.org. Cart 66 Lite is the popular one. In the last couple years, Jiko Shop and WooCommerce have come into the free shopping cart and have been doing really well. So let's look at WP e-commerce. It was one of the original shopping carts. If you looked 4 or 5 years ago, this was like one of the only ones, one of the only maybe three. I just pulled this from the plugin information. So it has 770 ratings, it has 3 stars. Part of the reason is that, it's been here for so long, but the other The other thing about it is that it can be buggy. As you can see, there's been almost 2 million downloads, and they keep it pretty updated. So those are all good reasons to take a look at this shopping cart plugin. It has great SEO. It's very customizable. It uses short codes and template tags. There's many payment gateway options. It offers coupons, quantity discounts, and it also does cross-selling. There's international support, and there's a whole slew of different shipping options, flat rate, table, or weight. Like I said, it's one of the original ones. Okay, so there are premium upgrades and plugins that you can get for this. Gold cards, which is not a very, it's like under $100, but it offers a grid mode, a thing called drop shop, which you can like drag things into the shopping cart that you like. And it also offers a membership subscription. And there's a bunch of other plugins for like different payment gateways and things that you can upgrade. It has great documentation. There's videos. They have forums. And if you can't see it very well, there's like the documentation part says an area for getting started, how you configure your stores, different themes you can use, and all the payment gateways. So they've been around a long time. There's a lot of people that have given a lot of time to documenting it. Okay, next is Cart 66 Lite. It's a very clean and simple e-commerce plugin. There's not really a storefront for it, so it's good for a small amount of products, and it does not have a catalog per se in the back. It was updated fairly recently. It has good requirements. There's a good amount of downloads, and again, it has a 3-star rating. It has a lot of the very basic standard features. For the free version, only PayPal and offline. Offline meaning people can look at your site, see the things on it, and they'll confirm you. Or send in a order form. Jig Shop. It's April 2011. So because of that, already having 98,000 downloads is pretty good. It has 105 ratings and it's 4 stars, so that's looking good. There's a nice integration of cross-selling, upselling, and related products in the shopping cart. And the one thing that I think is negative is that it uses post tables to store product data. So that means that along with your regular posts on your website, products will be like in there. It has a different category, but they're all in the post section. A lot of the other shopping carts, you have a separate section with just all the products. Again, JiggerShop has extensive documentation. It has good localization, meaning there's a lot of different languages. And this was interesting because you can group different products. And that means that you see here, here's an example of a computer. And on this example, they have grouped things like a mouse, a keyboard, a stand, a table. And that's like a group of products that, you know, if you're looking at this one, you can also buy these things and just add them to the cart. So that was a nice little feature that I haven't seen in too many of the other shopping carts. WooCommerce. It's only been around since September 2011, so it has considerably more downloads than JiggerShop. and it's a forced sterling. Actually, Booth Commerce was based on Jingo Shop. They were actually, I think, working on some on a project together and then split off for some reason and came up with this. So Booth Commerce is very flexible, easy to use templating engine. Lots of free and premium add-ons and themes. Of course, Woo themes, a lot of them support the WooCommerce, and it has great support. One of the interesting things that Woo themes offers is running a banner ad. You can just, there's a little section for it, and you just type in what you want and pop it in there, and you've got flash banner ads and coupons right on your site really quickly. Okay, so we've gone through the free ones. Most of the free ones have upgrade options. These are what we consider more of the premium things. Instead of Part 66 Lite, it's Part 66. The other one is MarketPress from WPMU Dev Group and Shop. So the Card 66, a single license is $89, which gives you 1 year premium support and access to the forums there. It has a very robust recurring payments process. And then it also has a great model for memberships and subscriptions. So if you're looking to that site, this is a good product to use. It uses live UPS, Postal Service, and FedEx shipping rates. And it integrates well with Google Analytics, Constant Contact, and Gravity Forms, to name a few of the things. The next one is MarketPress, and I don't know if any of you are familiar with WPMU Dev. It's a membership program. It's $419 for 1 year. They do have specials throughout the year to get into it, and they reduce that rate. But the monthly membership is $79. You can sign up for a monthly membership and then cancel it, but you can still, for that month, download all the products that you want. But it's an interesting site to take a look at. They have a lot of different plugins and things for you to look at along with good documentation on. The one thing that's interesting about this one is it actually has an importer specialized for WP e-commerce. So they're saying, we're better than this one, basically. Since it's a premium thing, we don't have the WordPress statistics for it, but I pulled this off of their site. They have a 5-star rating, and the people that are using it are rating it as 4.5. It's been downloaded 28,000 times, and it's good on WordPress, multi-site, and BuddyPress. So this one has lots of features. It has multiple payment gateways you can choose from, localization, and different chart codes. It also has a very flexible API and different theming options. The next one we're going to look at is Shop. It's a single site access. The single site access is $55. If you go up to the developer and things, it's more, but for $55, you can get this plugin. It has a lot of free and premium add-ons, and a very robust theme and developer API. It seamlessly integrates with WordPress, and they're really good with customer support and documentation. This is just a very vanilla looking shop. So getting back to my story about GemSmart. Last year, we went to our third version of Gym Smarts. This is what we came up with, and we're using Shop with an iFeature theme. It's not as graphically as pretty as the other sites, but it seems to be working well. Some of our considerations we use is that we need to be able to shop by coach and shop by category. So there's like two different levels of searching we needed to do. We needed to get details and spec section. So we wanted it to be very uniform. Shop gave us the details and specs, and we could, in every single product, have a presented by, language, record, runtime, all these different categories that we wanted in there. And then we could also put in our own links to other information on each of the coaches or products. It also had video on the product page that was easy to put in, and the ability to do handling fees. So another site that we've been working on is this Carolina Gym Supply. On this one, we chose WP e-commerce with Storefront Echo, and that was from Theme Forest. This is kind of an interesting story because we started this site with these are friends of ours. We started this site 3 years ago with them. This is their site until last July. A little bit old-fashioned, if I say, to be nice. And we told them they needed a more robust site, obviously. And so we were working with them for right away, about 3 years ago. They were really into it, and then the person that was doing the web left, and everybody else was afraid to touch it. And about 3 months ago, someone new came in and she was all excited to get a website up, and we were able to do that for them in about 2 weeks because all the product information was already in WP e-commerce, and all we had to do was kind of find an updated theme for them. So one of the considerations we had was that the client wanted orders to be requests for quotes only because obviously most of their items are very, very large and they don't use any of the standard shipping they use. Freight. So I just wanted to interject this. This is our TRV design site, and we just threw this together this week. So we have some things that we need to make it look better, but here it is for now. We just have a couple items that we sell off of this site. We have actually about 3 or 4 just DVDs that we sell off that site. So I decided, I think on Meva Merchant before we moved it over, and I decided very quickly, I just wanted a simple shopping cart, and I did a search and got 58 different plugins that we could use. So we chose this WP Ultra Simple Shopping Cart. I chose it because it had good ratings, it had recently revisions, and thank you, Dave. And so it's very easy to set up. We go to settings, ultra simple shopping cart. You get these different categories, the currency, everything. I think I set this up in about 15 minutes. Then you use short codes to put, this is just a page that I have, and you use the short code there to put into the buy button and this little thing at the bottom. Make sure that you have a shopping cart, and you're up and running on that. So I'm running out of time here. Some other thoughts to consider. Both of the e-commerce solutions will work with most mobile plugins and things. So it's very easy to both. It supports WP Touch and others plugins, and some of them actually are set up for the social commerce. Like plugins for embedding your store into Facebook. Some thoughts on themes. Many of the themes will work with all these different shopping carts. We use iFeature Pro for Gym Smarts, and when we went to look for the Carolina Gym Supply, what we did was we went into theme forest and we searched for responsive and e-commerce, which is the platform we were using. And we got 5 results and chose Echo Store Frontend. And I have to tell you, the support from the Echo Storefront was fantastic. The person gets right back to you and helps you out. And in one instance, he had to go into my back end and clean up some stuff because things were broken. But they were very good with the support. So just another comment on themes. Be wary of themes that have shopping carts built into them. There's been a discussion going on recently about themes versus plugins. The lines are getting really blurred. I don't know if you've noticed, you buy a plugin and it has a shopping cart or it has these different portfolios and things all in the theme. The problem with that is if you go to change themes, you lose some of the functionality that you have. So I just want to thank Boston WordPress Meetup, especially James, who's now in San Diego, Kurt and John Bishop for the Meetup group, because it's a great place to connect with people and learn things about WordPress. I especially want to, again, thank John Bishop and Brian Piccolo, from AMP Agency. A lot of this presentation was just expanded upon from their presentation at the April WordPress Meetup. I want people to be aware of some LinkedIn groups that I follow or that are on groups, and it's a great place to ask for information. And this is my information. So, any questions? Kind of rush through that.
Hi. I just wanted to say that I'm working on using my first shopping cart plugin right now. I'm using WP Ecommerce. And I am noticing that you do have to purchase the gold card upgrade if you want to have more than one product image, which I do. So that was just something I didn't realize at first, in case that's an issue.
More than one product
image? More than one product image per product,
yes.
You have to buy the upgrade.
It's a very good product lineup if you have that gold card on there. Any other questions?
Yes. Do you recommend any certain plugins if you're looking to accept donations? Like if your website's for a nonprofit, are there any recommendations, or would you just have a donation as a product?
If it's just as simple as a donation, I just go with a PayPal donation or Google donation button.
Does it have them?
Yeah,
okay.
They do.
One of them, you mentioned that they use the post type for, storing the data for the products.
Yeah.
Is WooCommerce like that as well? Or sorry, WooCommerce like that as well?
I believe so. I haven't worked with it a lot, but I think it does do it that way.
Okay.
Instead of a separate product area.
Gotcha. Well, I'm glad you mentioned that, because I wouldn't think it's still work with that.
Hi, can you tell us if any particular shopping cart works better integrating data feeds?
Integrating what?
Data feeds. Data feeds from merchants.
I do not have experience with the data feeds from merchants, so I don't know. But I haven't done that at all, sorry.
See, I'm wondering about upgrading some, and I know it's hard to say across the board, but have you ever upgraded any of the plugins for the carts? And have you ever had problems with those, or You just sort of stick with the current one you got.
Yes, I have had problems with that, but no, you should not stick with the version you have. You should. There's times where the upgrade for the cart might not match the WordPress upgrade. You may have to, you know, back down WordPress for a couple weeks, but I really recommend that you try and keep your plugins up to date. Okay. If you have any other questions, you can come and talk to me afterwards.
I have just one question. Okay. Are all these shopping cart options embedded in your site, or are they taking you to a landing page on another site?
The ones I went over, the six of them that I went over, they're all embedded on your site. There are plugins that will help you go to third party, but that's not what we're looking at here.
Okay, and I just wanted to make a comment. For anyone thinking of using Google Checkout, I've heard a lot of horror stories where if you have a problem, even though you are not at fault with payment, and even if you give back to people their money, Google will actually kill your analytics program and other services. So I would not recommend that for taking that for payment.
I would just say if you're in it for the long term, go with merchant services instead of going through PayPal or going through Google in general, because the payment on the credit card companies, you know, they will resolve any conflict, but it's much more reliable than you're getting paid, rather than at the whim of Google or PayPal to just cut you off and kill your whole business. Thank you.